gas. We're going to fuel up the trencher and get on the road. Don't know how long it'll be before we get there. Probably about an hour for me, maybe a few seconds for you. That's the way video editing works. Hello everyone. Today's going to be a little different. Normally, we'd be working on one of the rehab projects that I've got going on, but today I've got a family member needs some electric wires ran from the house out to a barn. So I'm dropping what I've got planned for the day and we're headed over that way. Got a ditch witch in tow. We're gonna trench my understanding is about 125 feet or so of ditch. And we're gonna put some direct burial cable, get everything wired up and make sure, hopefully, that we get some power in the barn. But it's promising to be a hot one. So we'll see. Well, stay tuned. It's about an hour drive. Hour for me, probably a few seconds for you, but in the meantime, enjoy this hour-long intermission of elevator music. I'm gonna go ahead and get it started now for you. I'll be back in an hour. Alright, well, here's where our main power comes into the house, and we're going to run a conduit down here to our shed back over this way. Let me see, I'll swing you around here where you can see. Way down there you can see the ditch going down to the barn. And I don't know if you can see, it's kind of little, looks like a water faucet, but it's down there is where we're going to be running into the barn. But get repositioned here, but we're going to be connecting in here now and getting our wire run. We went ahead and went with direct burial cable, but we're going to be putting it in conduit here so that it won't get damaged. And I hope it doesn't rain on us. But it looks like it might. Yay. Three with a ground direct bury. Well, if you got a huge conduit, you could run it through. Dogs are barking. Let's see if we can do this without getting electrocuted. Everything is done now. We got, it was about 125, well, just under 125 feet of wire. About 115 feet of ditch. Got everything trenched. Had to deal with going around some roots in the septic tank and other wiring and electric cables. Had to do some manual digging. My favorite thing of all times. Had to run that thing where you chop wood with, you know, what's it called? An axe, I think. But, yeah. So, anyway, we got the wire in, got everything hooked up. These are the things you do for family. But, you know, you don't make any money at it. But, quite frankly, it's the, you know, it's the positive things in your life that you do to help others that make a difference. And, you know, for that, all I can say is I just hope that, you know, that others follow in my footsteps and do things to help others, not only their family, but their friends and their community. But anyway, like I said, you don't make any money doing it, but the goodwill is more than worth it. And now that it's all done, I've got to get the Ditch Witch back before they want to charge me another day's rental. $150 a day. Well, $140 plus the governor's portion. It's all for a good cause. These are the things you do for family in need. I hope that, you know, somewhere somebody's keeping track of this. Maybe build up a little bit of positive karma. But anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.